Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back to another video featuring the Tonic Craft Kit number 27. This kit has a fall theme to it as well as a fairy theme. It is packed just like always with wonderful products and I have to say that it is definitely one of my favorites from the latest kits that have been released. So just like always, I'm going to do the unboxing so you can see what you get and then I'm going to share 3 cards using products from this kit. First of all, you will get a glitter marker. They have a whole range of different colors with these markers. The one that you get has a lovely fall color and to start the marker you need to press the tip on a piece of paper, shake it a couple of times. You have to be patient, do it a few times up and down, then you will see that the marker will start to write. It writes beautifully on white paper and it also works on dark cardstock as well. And you can also dilute it with water and use it as watercolor with glitter on it. If you are not familiar with the Nouveau alcohol markers, then this is a great set for you so you can try them out. You will get this set of 3 brown colors and I'm going to show you the color wheel of Nouveau alcohol markers so you can see which ones you will get. So these are the cookies and cream, the light browns. I have a whole video on these markers and how lovely they blend together and you can check that out. They have a fine tip on one side and a chisel tip on the other side and it is really easy to tell which side it is from the cups. Now, these blend lovely together, make sure that you use alcohol-friendly paper for that. Now let's take a look at the mediums that you will get. So 2 mini jars of a glitter drop and a dream drop. I'm going to swatch them so you can see the colors. This is the dream drop and it's called Fairy Wings. It is really versatile and I think it matches pretty much every project. And the other one is glitter drop and the color is pink champagne. The first one has a lovely pearlescent look and the second one has glitter inside. You also get a mini jar of glacier paste. This is a lovely paste that you can use directly with your spatula on your project, like I'm doing here, or through stencils. Now the color is Green Envy. And here is a close-up look on all the mediums, so you can probably see them better. And I'm trying to catch the light for you so you can see what's shiny, what's pearlescent, and what has glitter inside. In the kit you will also get 3 rolls of washi tape in lovely colors. I'm going to open them up for you so you can see the designs. One of them is a solid yellow. This one has a pattern with dots. And the last one has a lovely pattern with flowers. I love the fall vibe on this last one. And just like always, you will get your envelope with the dies and the stamp inside. This month you will also get a binder. You get one of these binders every 3 months so you can stay organized with your envelopes. And then you also get a sticker every month. I always like to stick the sticker on top of my envelope. And then let's take a look on what you get. Now inside you will find the dies as well as the stamp. I do get a sample kit every month, so my dies are not nicely organized inside the envelope. But they will come nicely organized for you, so don't worry about that. Now let's take a look on the amazing dies as well as the stamps that you get for this month. The stamps have a fall vibe to them. You get a pine cone, a mushroom, an acorn, and you also get these 2 stamps that match 2 of the dies. And you will see what I mean in an example as well. So let's take a look on what you get with the dies. These are the 2 leaves, the big leaves that match with 2 of the stamps. So you can see that these are going to stamp the vines inside the leaves. And now let's take a little bit about the dies. This is an amazing die set. First of all, you get 2 fairies. I'm going to use them on my examples today and you will see what lovely fairies they cut out. Of course, you get the 2 leaves, which are perfect for fall, a flower and another flower with a stem. And this die cuts out a lovely decorative vine. Now let's take a look at the dies. You can mix and match them to create different looks, from window cards to shaker cards to wreaths. I'm going to show you some ideas today. Now the larger of them is bigger than a standard card. If you like to create 4.25 by 5.5 cards, this is going to be bigger, but you can always use bits and parts of that, and I'm going to show you some ideas today. Now this is going to cut out only on the outside of the paper. But if you want it to cut out on the inside, you can use that ring as well. Here's another decorative tie that gives you this beautiful design. This fits on a 4.25 by 5.5 card. You can use this die with the bigger and the smaller circles so that you can cut out a ring if you want. Otherwise, it's only going to cut out a decorative design on your paper. And finally, here is the smaller of the dies. This is a pack of foam squares. These are large foam squares and you will get 24 of them in the package. They are 1 inch or 2.5 centimeters, but of course you can use your scissors to cut them smaller according to your project. And finally, let's take a quick look on the cardstock that you get for this month. Tonic Studios has amazing specialty papers, so you get samples every month, including satin paper, glitter paper, embossed one, in a lovely color combination. And let's start with the first card for today. For that, I'm going for a fall card and I will be using the two leaf dies. I'm going to start inking my two cardstock here and I'm using Distress Oxide ink. I went with a fall color combination and you can see the names on your screen right now. I am creating my own pattern paper so that I can cut out the leaves, and I'm not going to use Vintage Photo, the brown Distress Oxide ink, for now. I will be using that after I cut out my leaves. Notice that nothing has to be perfectly blended since I'm going to use those two backgrounds just for cutting out the leaves. And here they are all cut out. I'm going to use my Vintage Photo to go all around the edges just to enhance them a little bit. And now I'm going to use the two stamps from the set and stamp the vines on each of the leaves. For that, again, I'm using the brown Vintage Photo Distress Oxide ink. It doesn't have to be perfect. You don't need to layer anything really. It is very forgiving. I switch to the other stamp and I'm going to stamp the other leaves. And now I'm going to distress them even more by smooshing my Distress Oxide ink on my glass mat. I'm going to dilute it with water and then I'm going to use a thin brush to add some splashes all over those leaves. Once you create a bunch of these leaves, there are so many different ways you can put them on a card. They can be like one and a sentiment below, or three in a row and sentiment below. You can cover up completely a background with those leaves. I decided to create a window card for today, and I'm going to use the leaves to create a wreath. So as you can see, I'm starting with two panels. Both of these papers are from the kit. Having a touch of the same color on all the elements of a card really makes a difference and brings everything together. Now I'm going to use a smaller circle die on top of my panel. I'm going to run it through my die cutting machine and you can see here the outcome, a lovely window. You can easily turn this design into a shaker card if you want. I'm going with a simple window card for today. For consistency, and since I have inked up all the edges, again I'm going to ink up those branches with a Vintage Photo. I'm going to place one panel on top of the other temporarily so that I can stamp my sentiment inside, and I went with Best Wishes. I'm going to apply white embossing powder and then I'm going to heat set that. I used foam squares at the back for some dimension and I'm going to stick my panels one on top of the other. And now finally I'm going to lay the leaves all around that circle. I'm not sticking anything down yet, I just try to decide how many I need and how I'm going to stick them down. As you notice, this is going to cover up some of the design from the circle die, but it still leaves some branches to show, which gives a lovely element on my window. Now, to stick everything down, I'm going to use this craft glue that I got from the previous kit by Tonic Studios. I love that it doesn't dry super quickly, so I will have some time to move things around before I complete my wreath. And here is the finished outcome. You can embellish it with Nouveau Drops if you like. I'm going to leave it as it is, and here are some close-up photos. Moving on to the second card, and I used the two larger of the dies to cut out this lovely border out of black cardstock, and I also cut out the fairies. which I'm going to use later on my card. Now, first of all, I'm going to put everything aside and I'm going to start working on my background. For that, I'm working on watercolor paper and I'm going to combine a couple of colors that I absolutely love as a combination. Distress oxide inks blend beautifully together. You see, I'm not paying any attention on doing a perfect blending, but once I add a second layer, everything is going to blend beautifully. And when I am creating backgrounds with distress oxide inks, I cannot help it. I just have to add some water splashes on top of them. I'm going to leave the water to react with the ink for a few seconds, and then I'm going to blot them so you can see the effect. Now it is time to put my card together. First of all, I'm stamping with black ink my sentiment on a strip of white cardstock. I'm going to use foam squares at the back for some dimension. And I have a panel of black cardstock as my base. Now at the back, I'm going to use a part of this wreath, the beautiful design that I have. And you can't tell anything now, but you will see that it's going to give a lovely decorative edge once I place the inked background at the back. And I will be using this die cut all around my background panel to add some more interest. So you see, I will be using my glue at the back, stick a part on one side, and then cut off the excess. And having this inked background with black details on top, it really creates a very dramatic look, and I absolutely love the contrast. And here is an example on how you can use the larger of the dies in a completely different way than it was designed to be used. Now I'm using my scissors to cut off all the excess paper, and then I can stick that on top of my black panel. You can see that now I have lovely decorative details all around the edges. To complete my card, I'm going to stick down a fairy. I have foam square at the back to add some dimension, and this way it is completely leveled with the sentiment. Now, since this is a card about fairies and a magical world, I decided to add some gems at the background to add some sparkle. And then once I finished adding all those gems, I decided that my background was quite empty, and that's why I added one more fairy. And finally, let's move on to the last card for today. I will be using the green cardstock and that vine die. If you cut out three of them, you can create a full circle. And I also cut out flowers out of the purple cardstock. Now I'm going to work on a white panel and I'm going to stick down all those vines. So again, I'm going for a wreath card in a completely different style. I'm using my Nouveau Deluxe at the back on some of the leaves. You don't have to add it on everything. This way you will have some of the vines sticking out for some dimension. If you want, you can double up on the vines for a fuller look. I decided to leave it as it is, clean and simple. Now I'm going to add some dimension on my flowers. For that, I'm going to use this set by Tonic Studios. It's a great set to have in your stash if you like to add flowers on your cards. But in any case, if you don't have it, you can always use your fingers to add dimension and curl up the petals a little bit. And of course, this is a card that I will hand out to someone. Otherwise, all this dimension that I'm adding at the moment is going to flatten up if I add it on an envelope. Or you can alternatively use one of the box envelopes that are available. Now, for the sentiment, I'm going with Best Wishes again, which I'm going to stamp at the center of my wreath. And then I'm going to use my Nouveau Deluxe glue and start sticking down all those flowers. I also added dots at the center of my flowers by using the mini dream drops. You can call this card done at this stage. It's a very clean and simple design and very versatile. But I'm going to show you what you can do if you don't know when to stop, just like me. So here I cut out some more flowers from a white glitter cardstock, and I also cut out one of the fairies. And I cut it out twice, once of the purple cardstock and one more time from glitter cardstock. I'm going to use my scissors to separate only the wings, and then I'm going to stick those wings on top of my main fairy. And I added some dimension on the wings before I stick them down, so you can see the lovely effect. And you can do something similar with vellum if you want. Now I'm going to stick the fairy on top of my wreath to embellish it a little bit more. And then I'm going to also finish off the wreath by adding the white flowers as well. And I did use the Dream Drops again to add the center on the white flowers. And these were the projects for today featuring the new craft kit by Tonic Studios. I hope you had fun, that you got inspired. Down below in the description area you will find all the links that you need. Don't forget to like the video and leave me a comment. Thank you all so much for watching today, and I'll see you all next time.